thank you for joining us. We're here at the 15th Asian Airgun Championship in Daegu 2022, ready for the 10-meter air rifle women. So good morning, good day, good evening, wherever you're watching us from. Here is around 12 p.m. We're going to start in a couple of minutes. We are just in sighting series. These are the finalists from India, Elavelin Valerivan. Then we have from Kazakhstan, an 18-year-old. She's the youngest one, Alexandra Le. No final so far for her, so this is going to be a big one. On firing point C, we have Ayan Batispin, 23-year-old. Then we have the 22-year-old, Kim Dihe from Korea. Firing point E, Mehuli Ghosh, 21-year-old. She's a Silver Youth Olympic medalist from 2018 in Buenos Aires. Firing point F is going to be a Korean athlete, Cho Unyan.
Each firing in a
Bangladesh,
time of 250 seconds.
21-year-old.
After the 15 Cameroon shots, Kohli will be the third series. Place 8 and 7
and
will be decided.
Position H.
After next series of five
third
shots,
Indian athlete
and the fifth place
in the finals.
Will be
Meghana.
After one series more of 5 shots, fourth
Sajanad
and bronze medal will be
from,
the remaining two athletes will continue.
Kaido, she won
the,
match
on point.
Bronze medal with her team. The jury in charge, of course,
them.
We have our officials
in case of
working,
equal scores, both
working hard to make everything go as planned. The chief range officer Kim Nami, as well, and some supporters here we have in the stands waiting for the 10-meter air rifle women to begin. It's going to be the first final off today. Yesterday, the men were in most of the finals. And today is a little bit more reserved for the women. Later in the day, of course, we have the team events as well. But it's going to be interesting. Yesterday, last final was 10-meter air rifle women youth. And they were just incredible. So I'm expecting this to be a very interesting finals as well. Most of these athletes, most of the women here shooting, even though they're in the senior category, are pretty young, in their 20s, the oldest one being 28, only 28, actually, from India, Sajnad, going through the sighting shots, of course, before we start with the actual final. It's going to be three series of five shots before any kind of decision is made. After the three series, 7th and the 8th place are awarded. We continue on with another 5 shots for the 5th and the 6th place. And then another series of 5 shots for the bronze and the 4th place before we go on to the big finale, the finishing part of the finals, the gold medal match between the two athletes who remain. They're going to start from zero, but we'll go on more about that when we come to that point. Right now, we still have 8 of them, and they are still equally in a possibility to come to that gold medal match. Actually, Kim Dihu from Korea, she took the first place after the qualifications. It was a pretty high score. She went above that 10.5 of an average to get into the finals. Average of 60 shots that they do have in the qualifications to get into the finals, a 10-4. A little bit higher than that in average throughout the 60 shots was necessary. So it's a slight difference between, of course, the first and the eighth place that goes into the finals. But I'm sure we're going to see some very nice shooting. I already see it in the sighting shots. These women mean business. They are very serious about this. We're at the Daegu International Shooting Range. It's a big shooting range. What we're going to see here in the Asian Championship, since it's the Airgun Championship, mostly just this final hall, which is really beautiful, but it's a big shooting range actually that really has everything you need as a shooter. 25 meter, 50 meter, and a nice shotgun range. I walked a little bit around, and
stop.
It's a really, really nice range. I think we're ready. Of course, we have the ASC Vice President here as well, watching the finals, supporting the athletes, Mr. Kichiro Matsumaru.
Start.
And with this, we are ready to start with the finals. We are ready to start with the first series of five, and these first five series work as like a to show us a little bit who is where in the ranking, to get the athletes to show up and to build up their results as much as they can before the start of process of them going out of the finals, not being able to, you know, climb up that ladder anymore. So these 15 shots in the beginning give them a little bit of an opportunity to establish themselves into the finals. You can see the scoreboards right above them. And here we have it a little bit closer. I have to admit, I thought that we're going to start a bit stronger. These are a few slim 10s, but they have gone into a little bit of a stronger 10s with that second shot. A 10-9, a perfect shot. From Malay, from Kazakhstan, of course, right away taking that lead. A 10-9 will get you there for sure, especially in the beginning when there's not many shots to go in for just yet. But here they are, calm and concentrated. The coach is right behind them here. Coaches are always a very nice support in these finals. Not that they can do much. In the last part, they can have a timeout and talk to their athletes a little bit, but they're just here for support. So they do their part in the finals. It's not just sitting there. I'm sure they go through the finals sweating, but not letting that affect their calmness that they want to bring out and be there for the athletes as well. We're in the last shot of the first series. More or less, the athletes have gone a bit closer to the center, so it's a 10 meter of distance. The targets are very small, I gotta say. The 10 is like a dot on a paper. So we might be thinking, you know, the results sometimes could be higher, but it's not an easy thing to do at all. Cho has a nice group there, finishing off with a 10-8. That's almost the perfect shot that brought her back, brought her up into the lead and sharing the second place are Gosh and Lee. Lee had a good start as well, finished off with a thin 10, but still got to stay in the first three.
Stop.
After first series, the first place goes to Cho Eun-young from Republic of Korea.
Oh, there we have it.
And second place, Southerner from India. In third place, Ghosh from India.
So Janata finished up with a 10-7. That put her up in the first three. Which means two Indian athletes are now in the first three positions. And we've seen this happen in the finals yesterday as well. The Indian athletes are really showing up at this championship. And showing that they're really, really strong in this sport. So far, we've seen the rifle. I'm interested to see what happens with the pistol later in the competition as well. But most of the athletes in the competition are either from Korea or from India. So two very strong teams. Feels like it's a battle between these two. We're going to see what happens in this finals, though. Because the Kazakhstan athlete, Lee, keeps coming up a bit in the rank. She's doing a good job keeping up with these results. Not easy to stay calm and collected the whole time, but that's what's in the job description, isn't it? Yeah, we see some nice shots closer to the center. So as I said, 10 and a half or more is what's going to get you there. So aiming for the very center of the target. And even though it's a tenseful situation, it's not easy to shoot if you're shaking a little bit from nervousness, but these athletes, they do have this strong equipment with them. The jackets and the pants and the shoes. I don't know if we can see them. They're a little bit behind. A little bit above the ankle. So they're kind of hidden behind those trousers. They're keeping them stable and they're flat on the floor so that they can be as much on the floor as it's necessary. And that's keeping them tight and holding on as a statue there. Of course, their part of the deal is very big, but You have to have good equipment. That's for sure. That's why they all look pretty much the same. And I think we're coming to the end of the second five-shot series. As I said, this is kind of to establish where you are in the finals before they start coming out and letting the last two fight for that gold.
Stop.
After the second series, we have tied first place.
Oh, what a turnover.
But from Mongolia.
Mongolia
from
takes the lead.
And third place is Sadana from India.
With Korea.
The next series of five shots, place 8 and 7 Cho will be decided. At the
sharing the first position, and then we have the Indian athlete in the third place. Yeah, the Mongolian athlete actually had a very, very strong series. Strongest one out of any of them so far. A 53.2. That means some strong tens were there. Koli, she's currently on the line a little bit. Seventh place. Kim Diho from Korea as well, and she did not start with the best best shot, but we're gonna see. This is the deciding one. It's really important what they do right now, because this could get them up in the rank or thrown out of the finals. I'm sure the nervousness right now is a bit higher. Valerie Van, the 23-year-old, she won the World Cup final back in 2019 and three times the ISSF Junior Cup. Of course, a lot of these athletes have a lot to show. She also has a World Cup gold from Rio. Back in 2019, currently she's in the sixth place, so she'll want to stay there to try and get as higher up in the rank as possible. So Jannar ...28-year-old... the oldest one. She was 13th in the World Championship in Cairo, but did win the bronze with her team. Now in the finals with a little bit of chance, even though she's currently in the seventh position. It's not looking so good, and fortunately for the Mongolian athlete, she did get a few thin tens there, so she fell down in the ranking. And she keeps falling. Now she's in the sixth place. I guess that one very strong series got her a bit frightened. The 23-year-old was not able to hold on to that pressure. She also shoots the 50-meter rifle three position and actually has a silver from the Asian Championship back in 2019. Has a lot of competitions behind her, but maybe not as much finals.
Stop.
So it can be a little bit tense. And this is it. For now, it's going to be a tie for seventh place right
so
now.
So we have ties, place on the seventh. So congratulations for the finals on the seventh place. Sajanar Magna from India and Kim Ji-young from Republic of Korea.
Looks like they're going to be sharing the seventh position, seventh place.
After next series,
Meghana Sajanar, the 28-year-old, and...
at the moment, place six
Kim
is
Diha, the 22-year-old.
And fifth place, Valerie Van from India.
No need for a shoot-off there. But after three series, that's 15 shots. With decimals, they came to exactly the same score.
Stop.
It's going to be the two of them in the seventh place. And continuing on, next round, one more series to this side, the fifth and sixth. Starting off nicely, that was a 10-6. And a 10-7 from Cho. Oh, nice. Okay. Now we're talking. That was a 10.5. Lowest one for the first hit was a 10-2 from Colley. Started off pretty strong in this series. Pretty tense for the athletes here. Colley keeps going from fourth to fifth place. Do want that one more chance. The Mongolian athlete fell down to the sixth place. She was so good in that one series. Shooting well in the other one as well, but that one was that really got her higher up. If she can just come back once again for that. Try to squeeze her way back into the first four. Most of them, you can see that the results are pretty good. It's not easy to go through that competition. Because these women, they don't really make mistakes. And that was a 10-4. 10-4 for the Mongolian athletes. Iron bet. And I don't know, is that gonna be enough? Because Gosh is on fire here. And nope, the chances. No more chance right now, but that was such a slight difference, only
stop
if she were able to get
taking sixth place in the final
here.
And congratulations to Mila Ben and Balariban from India.
That was very, very close. Fortunately, going out of the finals, such a small obvious difference
from Mongolia.
In the sixth place.
After next series,
Valerivan, the 23-year-old from India, and the fifth place is going to be taken by the Mongolian athlete. Look at that difference, almost to nothing. But that's what happens in this sport. The Mongolian athlete, Ispinayan, but winning the fifth place, and now we are left with four athletes: Korea, Kazakhstan, India, and Bangladesh. To fight for those places on the podium. There are only three places on the podium, and there are four athletes.
For the next ranking match three, low. Start.
There we have it. One more series for the bronze. For the fourth place. And the scores are super tight. So it's hard to tell. Impossible to assume what's gonna happen, but currently Colley is in the fourth place, and with that slim 10 that she started with, not giving herself a lot of chance there, but she came back with a 10-6. Gosh, in the third position right now. Now she had a thin 10, meaning it could be an interesting battle with them. But now Lei had a 9 here, pushing her down down the ranking mat, down the rank, and Cho is just holding that lead, now even making it stronger with that 10-7. Lei coming back with a 10.5. And the coach is just looking at the scoreboard. Surely hoping, if not for the gold medal match, then for the place on the podium. It does keep looking like it's between Goshla and Colley, because they are so tight, so close with the results. Gosh and Lei were just tied for a second there. And Colley is just right behind them. She could get a strong 10 here for the last shot. That would be nice, but no, that was a slim 10 there, and she is not pleased with that. She knows that it could take her place away from her, from the podium.
Stop.
And let's see the finish of this. Look at that slightest difference of 0-3 between Lei and Colley, and the difference is a place on that podium, a bronze medal going to the Kazakhstani athlete Alexandra Lei, the 18-year-old, the youngest one. Very impressive. She did not have many competitions like this behind her, so that was a true success for her.
16 points are net needed to win this match.
And this is going to be now between India and Korea. Gosh and Cho fighting for the gold. We're starting from zero. They have a second here to talk to their coaches if it's necessary, but looks like they're in the zone. Not needing that. We're starting out with single shots, 50 seconds after each one. The score that is better wins 2 points. If they're tied, they each win 1 point, and we go up on until 16 for the gold, first one of the day of the Asian Championship. And a 10-6, nice to start off with such a strong strong shot. She got a bit of an applause. Let's see how the Indian athlete reacts. And that's going to be a thin 10 here. Not a perfect beginning, but it is pretty hard to go over that 10-6, especially in a very tenseful moment like this one. We do have 14 to go, at least Cho does.
Stop.
Again, 2 times in a row, nice. Oh, but this time Gosh was not playing
around. Get really excellent.
Almost a perfect shot.
2 points. Now we have two tied points of Cho Eun-young and Gosh.
Coming to a tie, is this going to be a hard gold medal match for these two? We'll see.
The medal match shot, low.
Definitely not the first time for India and Korea to have a duel like this. Yesterday we've seen that, pretty sure, four times in all those finals. Both of the nations are giving out some great athletes. And continuing on very strongly, Cho. Again, one thin one from Gosh.
Jonghyun got 10.7 score. She gets
even though there's
points.
Some music
Total
here,
score for Jonghyun, 4 points.
It
Gosh,
gets very,
points.
Very silent just before they're about to shoot. So even I'm trying. I definitely have the best seat in the house. Looking from up here, I'm trying to be a bit more silent, because. I can feel the tension in the air as well. Ten and a half. Nice. I think that's the lowest one she's had so far, but it's a very nice one, though. Gosh, coming back with a 10-7.
She gets another 2 points. Now we have again.
So she's dancing around the target a little bit, going from the thin 10 to a very strong one. So far, that was.
For the next medal match shot, low.
That was her style for this gold medal match. And Cho keeps it kind of in line of those. 10.5 or more. Let's see if Gosh can maybe stabilize a bit as the gold medal match continues. Oh, and that's going to be a thin one from Cho now.
Stop.
Enough for Gosh to take
Gosh
this
points,
situation, take advantage
Gosh,
of it,
six.
Win the 2 points,
Julian,
and take
points.
The lead.
For the next medal match shot, low. Stop.
It's always interesting to see them so calm, and you know that inside there is a storm they're battling. Sometimes with more success, sometimes with a little bit of less success. Oh, yep, that happens as well. She lost the lead, and now.
Stop.
That's going to be another 2 points for Gosh.
2 points. Total point for Gosh is 8.
Even a slim 10 here would be enough. But she went for that 10-7.
For the next medal match shot, low.
Stop. And coming back with a center of the target.
Stop.
Most what Gosh could have done here is win 1 point, and that would be on account of also hitting a 10-9, which I haven't seen in a long time something like that to happen. So a 10-9 is a pretty sure one to win the 2 points.
For the next medal match shot, low.
Cho is sneaking up a bit to Gosh back.
Stop.
She wins this round. Gets the tie, which would be a good comeback since she started with the lead. She had a pretty strong final. Oh, she's not happy with that one. The dynamics have changed now. Gosh is a bit more stable, while Cho is dancing around, hitting the center and then coming out.
For the next medal match shot, low. Start.
Ten and a half, will that be enough? Always shooting first though. Oh, look at that. The slightest difference.
Jo Unyang from Hwaebul, Korea, she gets another 2 points. Total score for Jo Unyang, 8 points. Gosh, 10 points.
There's still that one round of a difference between them. 2 points of a difference. 10 for Gosh, Cho with 8. We go up until 16.
For the next medal match shot, low. Star.
First again, a 10-4. She gets an applause from the stands, and that's the thinnest 10 you can have.
Another 2 points again.
By Gosh, meaning we have come to a tie. Well, they have come to a tie, both having 10 points.
For the next medal match shot, low.
So that's the rhythm that they have. Cho keeps hitting the target first.
Stop.
And then the stands get to react as well. It can play with Gosh's psyche a bit, maybe. The 21-year-old, I've already said, the silver youth Olympic medalist. That's a big deal. Back from 2018, that was 4 years ago. And that's going to be 2 points for her, back in
Gosh
that lead.
India, she gets another 2 points.
And only 4 points away
points.
Now from that, from that 16.
For the next medal match shot, low. Start.
Can Cho tie now? She was an Asian champion back in 2012 as a junior. It was held in Doha. Can she come at it as a senior now? Sure. It would be nice for her. 10.5. And again, this has already happened. You can see the disappointment, the surprise in Gosh's face of this happening once again. The women are tied, 12 points each. They both need 4 more. The first one to get it.
Stop.
Wins the Asian Championship. Oh, it's 9-10. But she's getting a bit of an applause here. And that's a
this round, Gosh,
stronger one from Gosh.
Match point on Gosh and Jo Unyang, 12 points.
Above that average, the audience can't even watch anymore.
For the next medal match shot, low.
I'm sure the Korean part of the spectators are very tense right now. This could be a match point for the Indian athlete if she wins this round. And a 10-3, will that be enough not to let... And two times in a row, oh gosh, just had it in her. She just had it in her to do it two times in a row, right when it was the most important time to finish it off, to win the match point at the 15th Asian Airgun Championship 2022 in Daegu, Republic of Korea. What a... breath of relief. And Cho is not the happiest here with how it all ended. She was fighting hard for that gold. In the end, Gosh came in, the 21-year-old.
Ladies and gentlemen, we congratulations for the bronze medal
from the Asian Championship.
We congratulations for the silver.
Here they are, all three of them. They will be on the podium.
Cho Eun-hyun
from Korea, silver medalist, and once again the gold medalist with those last two strong tens. It was they really gave us a show, I have to say. Thank you for watching. You can subscribe to the YouTube channel, official YouTube channel of ISSF, since the Asian Championship is being broadcasted on the ISSF official pages on Facebook and on YouTube. So check that out. We'll be having more finals throughout this championship, and the next one is at 1:45 p.m. local time. Comeback is going to be a final for 10-meter air rifle women junior, so I hope to see you again.